So we first heard of the Gamsby River through some local old-timers up here in Terrace. The Gamsby River is located approximately 120 kilometers to the southeast of Kitimat, and there it extends 55 kilometers before to reach the Kitlope River. And once you're on the Kitlope, you have another 30 clicks or so before to get to the ocean. Ali spotted this lake called Coe's Lake, which we could fly into, and once there we could hike about 4 kilometers through some meadows before to reach the headwaters. Once you get to the river, it's just a little stream, but after a couple hours it picks up volume pretty quick and then starts to carve its way through this classic coastal granite, and it eventually reaches some of the most beautiful untouched rainforest. And what was awaiting was just amazing.
The Kitlope Heritage Conservancy is hands down, bar none, one of the most special places on the planet. It's the largest untouched coastal temperate rainforest in North America. But mountain goats and mountain lions and grizzly bears and black bears and salmon and wolves and all of these, it's intact. It's an entire watershed that flows freely. And you really get the sense of that when you're there. You really get the sense of just this raw, rugged, wilderness as it should be, without human meddling. The story of the protection of the Kitlope started in the late 80s, early 90s, and for me and for my family, it started with my dad. He went on a fishing trip to the Kitlope and came across a layout crew and flagging tape, and they were proposing to log it, and he hooked up with the Haisla Hanaxiala people, whose traditional territory it is, and he hooked up with the Eco Trust, who had been enlisted to help build the profile of this place and the campaign to protect it. And so that journey started in the late 80s, early 90s, and one of my favorite stories about where the campaign started was when my dad first hooked up with these guys. He was a logger. He was a sawmill operator. He had never done conservation work, certainly not paid conservation work. And he didn't really know what he was doing, but he knew in his heart that he needed to share this place with people. He needed the world, he and everybody that he was working with needed to show the world the importance of this place. So they rounded up some money, they cobbled together enough money to hire a helicopter and a photographer to go in and capture these photos of this place, and that person ended up being Myron Kozak, who's later ended up being one of my dad's best friends, and he later died in a plane crash, tragically. But he ended up capturing these iconic photos of the Kitlope, which were used to show the world the beauty and grandeur of this place. And so they got that money from this guy named Yvon Chouinard, who owned this massive clothing company called Patagonia, and he heard that this guy apparently gives money out to people who are working to protect these important places. And so my dad, this 6'3", almost 300-pound guy, you know, comes up to this, you know, short guy, you know, who's you know, probably 5 foot nothing, and says, "Hey, I hear you give money to environmentalists." And this Yvonne guy at the time, you know, he said, "Oh, boy, here we go. You know, I've got this logger who's, you know, probably going to beat me up on the riverbank." And my dad said, "You know, how do you want to be? What do you think of being a part of protecting one of the last last remaining coastal temperate rainforest in the world. And Yvonne said, sounds good. You guys take credit card? And so that funded these first photos that came out of the cantaloupe. And from there, EcoTrust and the Haisla Hinoxiela folks, they told their story. And they told their story of their profound connection to place. And in 1994, under Mike Harcourt's government, BC government, they announced the permanent protection of the Kitlope Heritage Conservancy, which is now a Class A park.
That we seek and none forever breathe with the changes they will confront. You know, some people they just won't understand, or just won't understand what they say. Thank you for your message, but I don't understand, or just won't understand. Thank you. this sacred land. It has seen many hands, it has wealth and gold, yet it is fragile and old. And now the greedy souls just don't care to know of the changes it will confront. So speak out loud of the things you are proud of. Love this coast, then keep it clean as it holds, 'cause the way that it shines may just